Samantha, and I wanted to come to you briefly on a word, and that word is encouragement on ambush. Real quick, the perfect song is on right now. You got to stay prayed up, and that's key here, folks. I don't get on these scopes and claim to be anybody that's perfect, but I stand on let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom ye have redeemed from the hand of the enemy. A lot of times the enemy is crafty, and when I speak of the enemy, I'm talking about the devil. He comes to steal, kill, and destroy, but Jesus came to give us life and life more abundantly. Understand this, that God is a God of justice. He executes righteousness and judgment for all that are oppressed, and he will not allow us to be ambushed. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord lifts up a standard. See, the enemy doesn't play fair. He hits below the belt. But those that be planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. Let me say that again. Those that be planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. There's nothing hidden that won't be made manifest. Folks, I'm here to let you know one of the clear ways to ensure that you don't continuously get ambushed is to prepare ahead of time. And how do we do that? We can do that by sowing. We can do that by praying without ceasing. We can do that by calling things that be not as though they were. And understand that the Lord is aware of your situation. He doesn't want you to be ambushed, okay? See, the enemy prepares ahead of time, but he's not all-knowing. He's not omnipotent. Do you know that God is an on-time God? He said in Ecclesiastes 3 that under the heaven there's a set time for every purpose. Understand that God operates in seasons. In Genesis 8, he stated that as long as the earth remains, there'll be seed time and harvest. I'm here to encourage you, my friend, my brother, my cousin, my sister, future ambassador, future leader. See, the secret of the Lord is with them that fear him, and he'll show them his covenant. One thing that God said in Joel 2 was that his people will never be ashamed. So understand, the enemy may try to surround you like piranhas in a fish tank. I'm trying to tell you. But in Psalm 91, it states that no evil shall befall you, neither shall any plague come near your dwelling. Why is this? Because he's given his angels charge over you to keep you in all your ways. They shall bear you up in their hands, lest you dash your foot against a stone. I'm here to let you know, my friend, that God has a good plan for your life. There's nothing that qualifies me to say this. I'm not a part of the clergy. I'm not a minister. I don't work for the church. But I'm a believer that's on fire and excited. Back in 2015, December, 3 days before Christmas, I got hit by a car unexpectedly. And I'm going to tell you, it changed my life forever. But one of the things that it has taught me, I can't talk about it too much because there's a case still pending. But what I'm here to let you know is that I didn't have any broken bones. What I'm here to let you know is that the devil is mad when he sees the fruit of peace in your situation. You can speak peace over your families, peace over your children. I speak Isaiah 54:13 over my children. All my children shall be taught of the Lord, and great shall be the peace of my children. The enemy cannot just come in there and sift you as wheat, can't just power port you and jack you into a low place. The devil is a liar and he's defeated. I'm here to let you know that no weapon formed against you shall be able to prosper. Learn how to meditate on Isaiah 54:17. Don't let your good be spoken evil of, because I'm telling you, the enemy knows how to mask some things, but he does not have the power over your soul. I'm here to let you know that God is a redeemer, that his mercies are new every morning. Great is his faithfulness. I'm here to let you know, my friend, that you have a scroll, that before you were formed in your mother's womb, that God knew you. Hallelujah. Shadabasiata. So don't worry about what man can say. In Romans 8, it says, what shall we say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifieth. As you pray in secret, the Lord will reward you openly. I'm here to let you know, my friend, that despite what you may be going through on today, God is aware of your situation. You do not have to be ambushed, because there's nothing hidden that won't be made manifest. Is the devil digging in the trash again? Yuck, ill, and nasty. I'm here to let you know, my friend, on today, hallelujah, that God will redeem you. Hallelujah. He will set you on a new path. In fact, he says, no man having put their hand to the plow and looking back is fit for the kingdom. So the enemy has a choir of rats who want to sing your past. I'm here to let you know it has no power over your future. It's a sign of spiritual immaturity, but we are not superior over one another. So we speak the truth in love. Open rebuke is better than secret love, but I'm trying to tell you, the more the devil kicks and fights, the more he reveals his real nature. Hallelujah. And that's a nature to kill, steal, divide the flock, and destroy. There is no excuse. Love covers a multitude of sin. Love keeps no record. Hallelujah. Of the wrong. wrong done. So that's one of the main tactics of the enemy, is to reach back. When I reach back to find out what my recompense is. Hallelujah, glory to God. He said he will restore the years that the canker worm and the locust have consumed. You know what? I want to give a word to somebody on today that you're about to get, hallelujah, a supernatural release of blessings. You can believe that. Why? Because he's going to release it. So you see, cast your bread upon many waters. You don't know what seed is going to come up when, but the devil does not have permission, hallelujah, to ambush you, to bring you to such a low natural level. Say, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. I have a daughter that's graduating from high school next year, and I refuse to allow the enemy to ambush my daughter, to ambush my sons, to ambush me, to ambush my children. Here's my testimony. I'm divorced and co-parenting. I'm single. Ain't no ring on my finger, baby. But I'm here to let you know I've come under huge persecution. The enemy wants to dig in the trash, but I refuse to be ambushed. Why? Because there's nothing secret that won't be made manifest. We heard that story already. Hallelujah. You need to learn how to get to a place in God where you humble yourself and understand Romans 3:23. All have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. So you can tell that story over and over again. Devil, get thee behind me, Satan, in the name of Jesus, because you will not ambush me. You got to learn how to talk back to your situation and say, I will not be ambushed, because God is a good God. He daily loads me up with benefits. Hallelujah, glory to God. Understand, hallelujah, that God's got your back. Understand that you can put pressure on that covenant, because God is here for you and not against you. Well, until next time, understand, the ambush is over, and the best is yet to come. Shalom.